How do lagers factor into the widely varied craft beer landscape?
There's certain people want more exotic beers. There's other people that enjoyed a few beers I've let go since because of sales that I don't do anymore. I was determined to brew clean lagers. I thought they were underserved. I think that's the next glass ceiling, if you will, to tap into the next large chunk of the American population. You've seen craft beer sales slowing in the last several years. I think that's a little bit, as we get too eccentric and too honed in on overly niche beers, I don't think that's achieving the real goal, which is overall growth. I think the overall growth is going to come from tapping into your local community and tapping into the drinkable lagers, the beers that, say, my father's generation drinks. And I think we've done that fairly successful. If you're here on a Friday night, our age group is from 21 to 81, quite literally. A great blend of people drinking all the different beers we make. We may not serve the beer nerds enough in the sense of having that triple IPA often enough, but I think we serve the broader community. And I think that's important for the craft beer industry moving forward. And you're seeing more and more craft brewers dipping into lagers, dipping into clean, what they're calling crushable craft. I think that's the next glass ceiling that the industry has to shatter, or we're gonna be continuing to see stagnant sales.